Children are apple of the eyes of their parents. When a couple is expecting a child, they never ever imagine that their child will suffer from any disorder. But unfortunately, some children get affected by autism spectrum disorder, which is a developmental disorder. MediCircle is conducting World Autism Day awareness series to spread understanding about autism and to educate people so that they can help create meaningful lives of people around them who are suffering from autism. Hi, this is Amrita Priya, and you are watching MediCircle. We have Purvi Jadhav in our show on autism today. Purvi is a certified clinical psychologist and EQ trainer, specializing in children, teenagers, and marriage counseling. She is passionate about understanding children and teens and their issues. And she loves helping them to be happy, healthy, and productive individuals. So welcome, Purvi, to MediCircle.
Thank you, Amrita. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity.
So Purvi, to begin with, how is autism diagnosed? Is there a specific test for it?
So Amrita, generally at the age of 18, children start communicating through proper small phrases, maintaining proper eye contact, or walk small distances independently. Mm-hmm. However, some children may show some different set of behavior, like walking on toes. Mm-hmm. Repetitive behavior or repetitive action for hours, not looking at other person's eye, inability to socialize with their peers or their friends or siblings, getting really irritated with even small loud sounds which are very regular in our day-to-day life, like bursting balloon or clapping or even the city of cooker.
Okay. So,
even they see the through the side of their eye. Mm-hmm. They cannot show the if they are not showing emotional display. So this kind of symptoms are very common in autistic children. So when these children are showing these symptoms for more than 3 months, and most of the symptoms, whichever I mentioned, most of the symptoms when you are seeing in a child, then you need to consult or you need to inform your regular pediatrician. So mm-hmm. your regular pediatrician will do basic screening. They will ask you a couple of questions. They will observe the child's behavior and then send you to developmental pediatrician. Okay. Developmental pediatrician will do screening through the based on the American Psychological Association's DSM-5 checklist hai. If your child falls under those scale, then only they will guide you or they will tell you what to do in further.
Okay.
There are mild, moderate and severe autism problem. Mm-hmm. So based on the screening, you will come to know whether your child falls under this criteria or not.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, how is autism caused? Is there a genetic reason for that or hereditary reason for that?
So, specific causes of autism are not yet identified. Researchers are still exploring whether causes such as pollution, viral infection, side effect of medicine which mothers have taken and during pregnancy, even without informing or without the guidance of doctor, complications during pregnancy, and genetics. So genetics have a role in triggering autism. However, it appears that it is till now, the majority times, whatever cases we are seeing, it is more till now, I have come across the students or children who are like genetically, I am seeing that this problem is occurring in their family.
Okay.
So you can see, okay, Dada has some traits and father or mother has some traits. From anyone's side, they are getting this kind of genetical problems. So we don't know, but till now it is very sure it is genetical disorder.
So Purvi, what are the treatment options available for children suffering from autism?
Amrita, it depends upon the severity of the child, the condition. Pediatrician will suggest you the which therapist can help you the best. There are various therapists have their role to play to help the child. For example, occupational therapists, they will do certain exercises to make aware the child about their body. They improve their walking position. If the child is walking on toes, they make them walk on the foot, complete foot down. So this way, occupational therapist can help. Speech therapist, because of poor eye contact, the child always delay in speech. So speech okay. therapist will improve their eye contact and help them to learn speech and language easily, and keep continuing that to improve their comprehension. First, they will start with words, then two words, sentence, that they will start giving them pictures to understand the action and what picture is portraying. They will try to ask the child.
Okay.
And then they start helping them out to speak and comprehend the situation.
All right.
And speak about it. Speak it out, basically. Learn. Child psychologists will help them out to how to socialize, improve their socializing in school, even with how to behave in birthday party. How do you have to when the child is aggressive? How to handle them? Even they help parents to handle the child. They give okay. sort of training to parents as well to understand the child's aggression or a certain type of behavior where child is behaving abnormally, that they will help them out. Special educators will help them out to manage their or cope up with their regular studies, because most of the time they live in their imaginary world. They are less in interaction, so they don't have any they don't ask questions, or they will not answer when you ask questions. So this education special educator will understand the child's requirement of the studies. They will help them out and they will teach them the way they understand the topic. Even schools are providing shadow teachers. So as a doctor will suggest you can request school to provide you shadow teacher. Shadow teacher will help teach parents to manage child's day-to-day school routine, where they will see to it the child is attentive in the class, he is not left out, or he or she during recess time, he is able to or motivate them to gel with their peers, sit with them, have food with them. Even various art and craft activities are going on in the class. At least they will encourage them to work with the other students.
All right. So you were talking about shadow teachers. So shadow teachers are available in normal schools, isn't it? Not these schools specifically for autistic children, but they are now available in normal schools also to help out with children like
Yeah, so based on the new rules, even mild to moderate scale mein jo bachche hote hain autism ke liye, these children can study in school, regular school. Because autism, generally, there are no IQ-related issues are faced. IQ problem are in autistic children. Their IQ is completely fine. In fact, their concentration is very good. They are very good learner. So every school, ICSE, CBSE, every school has this compulsory rule that they have to provide shadow teacher to ADHD and autistic children whenever they are required, based on their recommendation. So autism, so whenever children who are autistic, they show very much aggression, or there are some symptoms associated with ADHD, that time pediatrician or psychiatrist might suggest some medicine which will control their behavior. So which
All
will
right.
help them out to cool down or calmer.
Okay. And as far as the shadow teachers are concerned, like they are available from kindergarten to class 10, you say?
Yeah, generally class grade 1 say they provide, because in kindergarten they have only capacity of 20-25 students, and generally in those classes you have two teachers, three teachers. But once child will promote to first standard, then they will have a subject teacher, or only one teacher is teaching all the subject. So that time the teacher, only one teacher is looking forward or looking after all the students. It will not be able to, it will not be possible for teacher to work with only one child or focus on only one child. That's why we require shadow teacher for the special children.
All right. So now that shadow teachers are being introduced in schools and all, so it gives a picture that the number of cases of autism or disabilities like this is increasing. That is why schools are adopting these new methods of supporting them. So what are the factors, according to you, which cause autism?
So first of all, earlier people were not aware about the more about developmental disorders. Now people are becoming more aware. It is good that people are reading about child psychology, developmental disorders. Even parents are more concerned about even small changes. If they notice in the child, they immediately inform to their pediatrician and immediately start taking steps for it. So as I told you earlier, there are no specific reason identified for triggering autism. However, we see cases are children showing some autism symptoms due to lack of attention from parents and less exposure of social environment. Though there are some cases, there are some children who are not as autistic.
Mm-hmm.
They are not facing any, or they are not having any developmental problem, but because of lots of time for screening or lots of time for TV or watching cartoons. In cartoon, you can't see the lip movement. You can hear only voice. Okay, so when you learn speech, you learn through the lip movement.
Okay.
So you can see child is delaying speech. There are many children who are coming that they are delaying speech. But when we go for intervention and we come to know that, okay, both the parents are working and they are not able to give time to their child, and child is spending lots of time on mobile or a mobile game or even with cartoon. Same way, parents don't have time to take children to garden or taking them out to play in building. So that time they are lacking behind in socializing. They don't know when you are meeting other friends that how to deal with other students. And when the age of 3-4, when they start going to school, they will realize it that my child is different than other child. They are not able to manage. Then school will start noticing the symptoms. Okay, this child is facing problem. They inform parents, and then that intervention starts. It may be that child is not autism, but it's showing symptoms also.
All right. So what I gather is that there can be very milder version of autism, or something which kind of looks like autism, but the reason is something else. The reason is the child is not getting company at home in nuclear families. Parents are busy with their jobs, and that is why there is developmental delay in the child, which looks like autism also. So this is also happening.
Yeah, so it's just showing, or you can say, the symptoms related to autism, but it is not actual autism. Even we cannot say that child is having mild autism, because again, it falls under that scale for mild autism. But we will not send them for mild autism as scale also, or all screening as well.
Okay, so the takeaway point is that autism is a disorder which happens, unfortunately, in children. But nowadays, we are seeing lots and lots of children who are kind of very introvert and showing symptoms which look like autism when it is not actually autism. And the reason behind is that now people are staying in nuclear setups, single child families, and parents do not have time to give to the child. though they would love to give time, but there are their own pressures. So this can also be
situation.
Children are kind of showing some differences.
Yeah, when you said that we are seeing autism in children, so autism is a developmental disorder. It will remain throughout with a child. When they become from childhood to their adulthood, it will remain with child. But the symptoms are more aggressive, visible during their childhood time or teen time, teenager time.
Okay.
Yeah. So it is not going to be like after 12 years or 15 years, you will not see that my child is not autistic. It will remain with them. But it is really good if they will help in a very early age, and parents should get aware about it. And if they start getting help, then definitely they can manage their life easily with autism.
Okay. All right. So it is a manageable disorder. The only thing is that it should be diagnosed very early.
Yeah, the more early, the more it is better for you and your child.
All right.
Because all the therapists will come in the picture in very early age. So even they will start managing child, and child will also get used to with the therapy and understanding all this. They are the way they help them out. So jab unka ye develop ho raha hai, learning process mein hi ye sab cheeze aa jaati hai.
Acha. So thank you, Purvi. You gave a bird's eye view of what exactly autism is. And also you touched upon some factors which are related to modern upbringing of children, related to working parents or related to busy parents and nuclear families. So it was a nice interactive session. And I'm sure people who are watching this video would be able to kind of give more time to the children, whether they are autistic or as it is, as parents. They should be giving time to children, and they're going to take away something from this video.
Thank you, Amrita. Thank you, MediCircle, for giving me this wonderful opportunity to talk upon autism. Specifically, this month we are celebrating autism.
Yes. So thank you so much, Purvi, to be the part of autism awareness series of MediCircle.
Most welcome.